church online. Who is ready for praise and worship? I am. Can I see your hands raised up if you are ready for praise and worship? Before we go into praise and worship, we will typically pray. Let us pray. Father, we say thank you. Thank you for bringing us to church today. We are super grateful for that. We ask in the name of Jesus that even as we praise you, that you accept our praises and you accept our worship. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'm not a warrior, I'm too afraid to lose. I feel unqualified for what you're calling me to. Lord, with your strength, I've got no excuse. 'Cause broken people are exactly who you use. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Boy, and made him a king. So I'm gonna trust you and give you everything. I'll be a conqueror, 'cause you fight for me. I'll be a champion, claiming your victory. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion. Shake the wall, won't stop until I see them fall. Gonna stand up, step out when you call. Jesus, Jesus, I'm gonna sing and shout and shake the wall. Won't stop until I see them fall. Gonna stand up, step out when you call. Jesus, give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David. Lord, be my defense, so I can face my giants.
It's an open heaven. You're releasing, and we will never be denied. Cause we're stirring up deep, deep wells. We're stirring up deep, deep waters. We're gonna dance in the river. Stirring up deep, deep waters. We're gonna jump in the river. Jump in the river. Deep cries out to, deep cries out to, deep cries out to, deep cries out to. We cry out to, we cry out to you, Jesus. I've got a river of living water, a fountain that never will run dry. It's an open heaven, you're releasing, and we will never be denied. Cause we're stirring up deep, deep wells. We're stirring up deep, deep waters. We're gonna dance in the river. Dance in the river. Stir it up, deep, deep waters. We're gonna jump in the river. Jump in the river.
Everybody sing it out.
Deep cries out to, deep cries out to, deep cries out to, deep cries out to. We cry out to, we cry out to you, Jesus. Deep cries out to, deep cries out to, deep cries out to, deep cries out to.
If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. And if he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're gonna jump, 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 jump in the river. Jump, 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 everybody. If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. And if he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're gonna dance, 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 dance in the river. Dance, 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 everybody. If he goes to the left, then we'll go to the left. And if he goes to the right, then we'll go to the right. We're gonna shout, 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 shout in the river. Shout, 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 shout. Deep cries out to, deep cries out to, deep cries out to, deep cries out to. We cry out to, we cry out to.
You are my strength, you are my strength.
treasure forever. Yes, we'll be together always.
Shout it out without a
To the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
You are here, moving in the midst. You never stop.
Father, we say thank you. Thank you for all that you do. Thank you because we know you are the way maker. You are the miracle worker. You are the promise keeper. We ask that you help us, even as we go to study your word, that you will teach us yourself and you will transform our lives. For in Jesus' name we've prayed. Amen.
Good morning, children. Good morning. How are we today? Oh, yes, we all are good because this is our season and our year of being limitless. Great. Now, the first thing we do is to say our good morning. So turn to your neighbor and say good morning. Turn to your other neighbor and say good morning. And what do you do next? You wave your hands and say good morning, good morning, good morning. Now, let's all sit down quietly, eliminate all forms of distraction. We're about to dive into the Word of God. Great, great, great. So now let's bring out our files, all neatly packed up. Okay, I love the color of your file. It's really nice. Oh, you put butterflies on your file. It's pretty, it's pretty. So let's go back to business. Let's check. Your notebook, your pen or your pencil, your fresh fire, your Bible, and your offering. Great, you have them all. Good. Now, who remembers all we talked about last week and last month? We talked about the Word of God, how we need to pray and we need to think good and we read and we sang, read your Bible, pray every day. Yes, yes, yes. It was an amazing month of March. Now, today, we're about to start the new series because we are in the month of April. Wow, just yesterday that we entered January and we say, Happy New Year! And already, we're in April. Isn't God amazing? Yes, God is awesome, God is big, and God is so cool. Now, this month, today is Thanksgiving Sunday. Remember to say thank you, Jesus, and give him all the thanks. This month, the series is about the Living King. Yes, and today's topic is Living King, Baby King. The Living King. Why are we talking about the Living King and the Baby King? Who can tell me? Who can tell me? Yes, because we are in the month of Easter. So we're going to have a lot to talk about for Easter. You know what Easter is all about? The death of Jesus and the resurrection of the King of Glory. Yes, this is the season where we had, who is the King of Glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. He is the King of Glory. Yeah, we're in Easter, where Jesus conquered the enemy and he conquered death and he brought shame and reproach to death. Yes, our King conquered death. He rose up from the dead. And he is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he is your King. And he is my King. Now today I'm going to be telling you a story. I know we like stories. Let's all listen. We have Cynthia and we have James. What are their names again? Cynthia and James. So Cynthia says, why do we fuss about Easter? Remember I told you that this is April and this is Easter? Great. And James says, baby Jesus. And Cynthia says, huh? Imagine someone says, why do you fuss about Easter? And you just say, baby Jesus. But we know what it means because we are children of God. And then James says, long before Jesus was born, many sons and daughters of God spoke and wrote prophecies about him. And guess what? Cynthia says, what? James says, Jesus showed up and fulfilled every single one. Isn't that awesome? Jesus fulfilled every prophecy that was ever said about him because God is not man. He doesn't lie. Now he goes further to say, baby Jesus was the one God spoke about in the garden of Eden when he said to the serpent in Genesis 3:15, her child will crush your head and you will bite his heel. He was the one Abraham was also speaking about when he told his son Isaac, God will provide a lamb for himself. How awesome is that? How cool is that? Like, God spoke about Jesus as well, not just the prophets. Of course, we all know that God is the inspiration to the prophecies that came forth. But God has great plans for us. So even before Jesus was born, even before Jesus was sent down to the world to come and save you and I, God already knew he was coming. That's why we say, let's put our trust in God, because he sees way ahead. He sees the future that you can't see and I can't see. So when we worry, why do we worry? We just go to God. We pray. We say, Father, help me get through this. Because God knows how the end is going to be, and the end is going to favor us because God loves us exceedingly and abundantly. Cynthia replies, really awesome. James says, absolutely. And on the day Jesus was born, everyone that visited him worshipped him as king, even though he was just a baby. Wow. On the day Jesus was born, everyone worshipped him. Everybody knew that he was the king of glory. I guess they said, all hail the power of Jesus' name, let angels prostrate for.
Ring for the royal diadem and crown him Lord of all. Ring for the royal diadem and crown him Lord of all. O seed of Israel's chosen race, now ransomed from the fall. Hail him who saves you by his grace, and crown him Lord of all. Hail him who saves you by his grace, and crown him Lord of all. Let every tongue and every tribe on this terrestrial ball,
so great. They all worshipped him. They all bowed before him. We all worship him and we all bow before him. And Cynthia said, I have always wondered about that. How could those wise men bow to a baby? Surely they must have felt funny. Do you think they felt funny? No, because they knew that Jesus was special. Jesus was the king that would come to save you and I. So no, they didn't feel funny, they didn't worry. And that's why we as children of God need to know that God has the solution to all our problems. And we should trust in him and we should bow down to him, because we know that Jesus has got each and every one of us. So James says, not at all. God had shown them a very special star, announcing that the King of Kings had been born. Why else would they travel for many months carrying expensive gifts fit for a king? Jesus was no ordinary baby. No way we said Jesus is special. He was no ordinary baby. The star was in the sky, and everywhere was lit up, and the king was born in a manger.
Remember when God created a perfect garden? He also created a perfect family, Adam and Eve, to live in the garden with him forever. All they had to do was trust God. Then they would live with him forever in a perfect world where nothing bad happened, ever. Unfortunately, Adam and Eve stopped trusting God, so they disobeyed him. That's when all the wrong things in the world began. The worst part was they were separated from God because God is perfect and can't be around anything wrong. But God came up with a plan to rescue us from all the wrong things in the world. That way, he could be close to us again. For hundreds of years, God planned this rescue. He built a special family for the rescuer to be born into. He told prophets how to recognize the rescuer when he came. Prophets hear from God and then share it. God's family was so excited. And finally, it was time. God was ready to send his very own son, Jesus, to be with us on earth. Of course, he could have sent Jesus as a warrior or a superhero, but he didn't. He sent him the same way we all get here, as a baby. Now, that might not sound strange at first, but to a young woman named Mary, it was a huge surprise. God actually sent an angel to tell her that she was going to have a baby named Jesus. Mary was terrified, but she said, "I serve the Lord. May it happen to me just as you said it would." Basically, Mary wanted what God wanted. Anyway, the news about Mary's baby also came as a big surprise to a man named Joseph. Mary was going to be his wife, and now she was going to have a baby. But Joseph wasn't the father. So an angel came to him in a dream. He said, "Don't be afraid to take Mary home to be your wife. She will give birth to a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." After hearing that, Joseph obeyed. A bit later, the king told people to go to their hometown to be counted. That was something that happened every once in a while. Joseph was from a little town called Bethlehem, so that's where he and Mary went. When they got there, Mary and Joseph couldn't find a place to stay. With nowhere else to go, they spent the night in a place where animals were kept. And that very night, Jesus was born. Mary laid him in a manger, which is where animals eat. Here was the King of Heaven, the perfect rescuer, born with animals and sleeping in a dirty feeding dish, because nobody would make room for him. Kids, have you ever felt like nobody wanted you around? Well, that quiet, lonely moment was the moment God's whole family had been waiting for. So God did something special. He sent angels to some shepherds who were taking care of their sheep nearby. The angels said, "Today, your Savior is born in the city of David. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger." The shepherds went to find Jesus right away. They told others the news. "The rescuer is here, and he is sleeping in a manger." Everybody who heard their story was amazed. This is what they had been waiting for. It just happened in a way that wasn't expected. Even though people had stopped trusting God, he loved them and us. He wants to be with us so much that he sent his very own son to earth to live as a man. In fact, one of the names God called Jesus was Emmanuel, which means God with us. Through this tiny baby, God was close to his people again. And that's the story of when Jesus was born.
The baby king, the baby Jesus, who would grow to become the Jesus that we all know as our Lord and personal Savior. So small things, big God. Even though Jesus was a little baby, he was a big king, a great king, a king that would save each and every one of us. a king that we will call upon in times of trouble, and he will come and save us. A king that we will pray to, and he will answer us. A king that will provide for us. A king that loves us deeply. A king that will not let the enemy win against our lives. A gentle king, a kind king, a loving king, a powerful king. That baby Jesus is the Jesus that is our God today. Aren't you excited? Like, this season of Easter is going to be so mind-blowing. We have so much to unpack from the fresh fire. You don't have your own fresh fire. Just ask mommy or daddy to come over to the church office and they'll get you one. Because there's so much we're going to learn. And I know you need yours so that you can be a part of this experience. You know, during the week, you keep reading your fresh fire and studying. There's so many Bible passages to learn about Jesus. Okay, so you get yours. Just ask mommy or daddy. Now, what we're saying is this month is special. It's the month where our king conquered the grave and gave us victory. And this is the month where we, as partakers of this victory, will have victory in every area of our life, just like we've had every other month, and we're going to have every day of our lives. So congratulations. You are a child of the baby king, the living king, the great king, and the one and only king, Jesus. Fantastic, fantastic. So now let's go to page 39. Now, can you see the picture? Those are the three wise men who came to worship the baby king. No wonder Jesus calls them wise. Like, they came with expensive gifts, and they came and they served and they bowed down to the King of Glory. Now, even though Jesus was just a baby, they knew that Jesus was no ordinary baby. So we're going to paint it. Can you see the horse and the sheep and the ram and the donkey? Yes. And can you see Joseph and Mary? You can. Can you see Jesus? Yes, you can. So we're going to paint the manger and paint all the amazing people that are in this picture, because they're very, very important to us and to the story of our living king and our baby king, Jesus. Who can tell me what they learned today? Yes, we learned that Jesus is our living king. And even though he was a baby, he already had great potentials, and he was worshipped, and he was served, and the light of God was upon him. The star was in the sky, and he directed the three wise men to him. And he is born! He is born! The King of Glory is born! Yes, 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 fantastic. So it's time for us to take our life application. So now, let's all stand up. Put your right hand where? On your chest, and repeat after me. Easter is very special. Jesus is the promised king. Jesus is the living king. Now let's take this again together this time. Easter is very special. Jesus is the promised king. Jesus is the living king. Now let's sit down quietly. Don't push your chairs and don't push your sibling. Sit down quietly. It's time for us to take our memory verse. Are we ready? Okay. Our memory verse is taken from Acts chapter 4, verse 12. And it says, Jesus is the only one who can save people. No one else in the world is able to save us. Now let's take this again together. Our memory verse is taken from Acts chapter 4, verse 12, and it says, Jesus is the only one who can save people. No one else in the world is able to save us. That's so deep. Nobody can save us. We can't give our lives to anyone to take care of. Jesus is the only one who can save you and I. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let the earth hear his voice. Praise God. So now let's take our prayer. We want to pray. Close your eyes. Put your hands together. We are going to say our prayers. Say, Father, I thank you for Easter. And thank you for giving us King Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Today's Thanksgiving. Always thank him. Remember that you should be in a place of thanksgiving and thanksgiving, because we have to live our life giving thanks to the King of Glory, to the living King. Great, great. It's time for us to go. But before we go, remember we have to check our hygiene. So now, let's do this together. One, two, go. Wash your hands, clean, clean, clean. Wash your hands, clean, clean, clean. Wash your hands for how long? 20 seconds. Use your sanitizers, your face masks, and your face shields. Remember to practice social distancing. And when you want to cough, you don't cough. How do we cough? Let's do this together again. We cough. And remember, don't touch dirty surfaces. So for me to you, till next time, it's bye-bye.